All right, prime numbers. Important in modern cryptography. Mathematicians love them. Let's find out how to make some in Python. I have a basic setup here. I'm going to import time so that I can time my code, show you how to find primes in an efficient and fast manner. We're going to ask the user how many primes they want to find, and then I have this loop right here that's going to count, find and count up all those primes. First things first, I got a few mistakes. Not.len right here. Length is a function that will take the list as input, and I'm going to need to convert the input to an integer right there. All right, with that fixed up, let's go ahead and write an isPrime function. So this is a function that is going to take an integer input, and it's going to return true or false. True if the input is prime, false if it is not. I'm going to start off with a very basic isPrime function. This function is going to loop over the numbers from 2 to 1 less than our input x, and it's going to see if x is divisible by any of those numbers. A prime number is not divisible by any whole number other than 1 or itself. So if the number is divisible by any of those things, well, then it's not prime, so we return false. And only after we've checked all of those possibilities at the end of that for loop can we return true. I'm fixing another little mistake right here. I don't want to subtract 1 from x. Range goes up to, but not including its second argument. So putting x right there is perfect. Let's say a little bit more about line 3 of this code. The x percentage sign I equals 0. What exactly is that doing? Percentage sign is the modulus operation. That means that it's going to take x divided by I, but instead of giving the result of x divided by I, it's going to give the remainder. If x is divisible by I, that means I divides in evenly with no remainder. The remainder is 0. And that means it is not prime and we should return false. Without even timing this code, let's make a few efficiency gains. We can test to see if x is divisible by 2 right away, and then we never have to check any even numbers. We can just start at 3 and go up by 2 each time. And we should also check to make sure that x is not 2 itself, which is of course prime. I'm not using the most accurate timing methods, so my times are going to vary on different runs. But we can see here that it works for 100 primes, 1000 primes. It gets a little slow at 10,000 though. In fact, so slow that I gave up on it. But there's a way we can greatly increase our efficiency. Let's think about 100. 100 is divisible by 2. 100 is also divisible by 50. A number is never only divisible by one number. It takes two multiplied together. Except in one particular case. The square root of a number is precisely the number, when you multiply it by itself, it gives you the number you started with. For every factor that's not the square root, that factor is multiplied by a different factor to get your original number. And one of those factors has to be less than the square root, and the other one has to be greater. This means that we don't have to actually look at all those bigger numbers, we can just focus on the smaller ones. Here's a graph of x over 2, and here's a graph of square root of x. For small values, we see that the square root of x graph is actually a little bit higher than x over 2. But as we zoom further and further out, the x over 2 graph grows much faster than the square root of x. When given a large number and asked to determine if it's prime or not, the program is going to save a ton of time by only testing values up through the square root of the number. So here we'll make that modification to our code. I put in the square root plus 1 to make sure that we include checking the square root. I'm going to need to import math to use the square root function. The value also needs to be an integer, otherwise range will throw an error. I'm speeding up the timing on all these, but you can see by the printout that this is a big efficiency gain. This is probably the single biggest efficiency gain that we can make, but I'm going to go a little bit further by keeping track of the primes that we've seen so far, and then only checking to see if our new number is prime by dividing by those previous primes we've already discovered. So I'm going to need an array for this. I've named it all primes. I'll start by checking if x is in our all primes list, and then I'll have a for loop that goes through and checks if x is divisible by any of the numbers in our all primes list. As long as the last number in our all primes list is less than the square root of the number that we're trying to check to see if it's prime, we need to extend our all primes list. Python actually lets you use -1 as an index that just refers to the last element in the list. But I'm going to use length -1 because I think that's more common in a variety of languages. We're going to keep all our old tricks of using the square root and also increasing the divisor by 2 so that we're only checking odd numbers. I want to initialize the divisor as the last prime number that we know of in our all primes list, plus 2, and I want to do that before the while loop, and inside the while loop I'm just going to go up by 2 each time. Lastly, when I detect a prime number, I'm going to add it to my all primes list, so that as it looks at higher and higher numbers, it's going to check if those numbers are prime and automatically add them to the all primes list. To do that, we're actually going to make this isPrime function recursive. It's going to call itself to check individual numbers as it's building up its list to check if x is prime. Whenever a new prime number is discovered, it gets added to the list. Finally, not only do we have some very efficient code, but the more this function gets called, the more efficient it gets. The larger the all primes list grows, and the better we get at finding larger and larger prime numbers. I'm not claiming that this is the most efficient way that we could possibly find prime numbers. You might see opportunities for consolidating the two loops that we have, for example. Another exercise somebody could do is actually be scientific about measuring the speedup. Get a statistically significant sample size and determine, is it actually faster to add the primes to the all primes list, or were we doing better with just the square root? There's lots of interesting things that can be done with prime numbers, so I hope you find some applications of your own and enjoy.